Station. My name is Mr. Talon, teaching mathematics for GSS level. As you have learned in the previous lesson about simultaneous equations, you must have learned about various methods used in solving any simultaneous equation, the elimination method or substitution method. So I'm going to just add some amount of salt and sugar to what you have learned in the previous lesson, one previous tutorial. So let's take a look at example number simultaneous equation. Example number one, we are asked to solve a simultaneous equation. That is x plus y equals 7. So we have x plus y equals 7. And 3x minus y equals 5. The first thing you need to take note of, in solving any simultaneous equation, there are basically two equations involved. That is, the first one will label it as equation 1, and then the second one will label it as equation 2. Now, let's say that we want to use elimination method in solving this particular question. Now, we also got still a group of different methods used in solving this particular question. Now, the first thing we need to do in any simultaneous equation, we have to find the values of the letters given in the question. Meaning that we have to find the value of x and then we find the value of y. Now, finding the value of x or the value of y in this given question, all we need to do, we have to add equation 1 and equation 2. You might be confused if you want to ask, why are we to add, not to subtract? Whenever we have positive and negative signs, then we simply need, we have to add equation 1 and equation 2 together. But if the signs are the same, then we subtract equation 2 from equation 1. Let's go back to this is the given question. I said we have to add equation 1 and equation 2. Why are we to add equation 1 and equation 2? Because the sign cannot be the same. We are going to look at different approaches and solve our question. Using different approaches, we arrive at the same answer. So let us add equation 1 and equation 2. You are going to solve. So we take equation 1 is x plus y, keep the y at the 7 constant, and then we take equation 2, which is plus 3x minus y, everything must be equal to 7 plus 5. You might also get confused because you are not used to this method. After using this method, I will then solve the same question using the method that you are familiar with. Okay? So, adding equation 1 and equation 2, because the signs are not the same. If the signs are the same, then all of us will have to subtract equation 2 from equation 1. So adding equation 1 and equation 2, we take x plus y, keep this one constant, then 3x minus y equals to 7 plus 5. Now we correct like that. The right terms are x plus 3x plus y minus y. So we now say x plus 3x plus y minus y equals to 12. Plus y minus y cross out. Why? Because the coefficient of y is 1. So plus 1 minus 1 is 0. So plus y minus y cross out. After which we are left with x plus 3x, which is equals to 4x, equals to 12. In finding the value of x, all of this will be divided both sides by the coefficient of x, which is 4. What do I mean by the coefficient? The number is the coefficient, and then the letter is the variable. Don't get confused. The number is the coefficient, and the letter is the variable. Supposing it was 5x, let me divide I do high qualified. So only people see eggs in my book and my feet. But because here we have four eggs, meaning that we have to divide both sides by four. So four and four cross out to the left hand side, and then we have six eggs alone. X now is equal to 12 divided by 4, which is 3. You might get confused because you are not used to this method. You might use another method, but don't worry, I'm going to solve the other method so you learn as you move along the line. After finding the value of x, all we need to do, we have to substitute the value of x to 3 in either equation 1 or equation 2 in order to determine the value of y. We have to substitute x equal to 3 in either equation 1 or equation 2 in order to determine the value of y. I might decide to substitute x equal to 3 in equation 1. You might decide to substitute x equal to 3 in equation 2. Regardless of the equation we substitute x equal to 3 in, the value of y must always be the same. So let us substitute x equal to 3 in equation 1. So we take note of that and we say, substitute x equal to 3 in equation 1. That is, we like to have equation 1. Well, equation 1 are x plus y equals to 7. Wherever we see x, we now replace x to 3. So you are the ones of the letters all together. So the value of x now is what? 3 plus y equals to 7. In order to determine the value of y, take the plus 3, move the plus 3 over to the right hand side. Clear? Move the plus 3 over to the right hand side. When you take the plus 3 from the left to the right hand side, automatically changes. So because the plus 3 is positive on the left hand side, moving the plus 3 from the left to the right, the plus 3 automatically changes to minus 3. So on the left hand side, we have to reach y equals to 7 minus 3. So y now is equal to 7 minus 3, which is 4. So we are going to determine the value of x and then the value of y. Let's look at another alternative method. So we now say alternatively, alternative method in solving the same question, and we must arrive at the same answer. Now let's say the question again. We have x plus y is equal to 7 and 3x minus y equals to 5. We underline. The word eliminate simply means to cancel. The first thing we need to take note of when using elimination method, we rule out if the coefficients of the variable are the same. What do I mean by that? Remember, I said earlier on, the coefficient simply means the number and the variable is the letter. Now we have the coefficient of x, which is what? The coefficient of x is 3. They are not the same, so we don't have the right to eliminate. We take a look at the y. The coefficient of y is 1. The coefficient of y is also minus 1. So we cross out the y. So we eliminate the y. After we have eliminated the y, and then we have minus constant. That one is constant, don't ask y. That minus is constant. How much is whether we have to add or to subtract? Plus times minus is minus. Minus times minus is plus. I repeat. Plus times minus is minus. Minus times minus is plus. So meaning that x plus 3x is 4x. You might want to know why x plus 3x is 4x. Remember, the coefficient of x is 1. But we don't have the right to write 1 in 1 or any letter. So 1x plus 3x is 4x. 4x equals to plus times minus minus. Minus times minus is plus. So 7 plus 5 is 12. Finding the value of x, we now divide both sides by the coefficient of x, which is 4. So we divide 11 by 4 and divide 11 by 4. 4 and 4 cross out to the left hand side and then we have 3x. X now is equal to 12 divided by 4, which is 3. So you see, we get the same answer using this same method. After finding the value of x, we can now substitute x equal to 3 in equation 1 or equation 2 to determine the value of 1. When I was using this method, I substitute x equal to 3 in equation 1. Now, using another method, we are going to substitute x equal to 3 in equation 2. So we say, substitute x equal to 3 in equation 2. But for better understanding, you must write what we have as equation 2. So we say that is where equation 2 are 3x minus y equals to 5. Wherever we see x in this equation, we bring the x to be 3. That's why we say substitute x equals to 2 in equation 2. Solving together now, we say 3, the value of x is what? 3. 3 into 3, bracket 6, minus y equals to 5. Now we expand. To expand simply means to get rid of the bracket. So 3 times 3 is 9, minus y equals to 5. When you reach to this point, there is no need for you to get confused. All of you need to do is 10 plus 9 over to the right hand side. Because we want to find the value of x, sorry, the value of y. So 10 plus 9 over to the right hand side. Then on the left hand side, we have left with minus y equals to 5, which is coming down to the right hand side, plus 9 moving over to the right hand side becomes minus 9. So minus y now is equal to 5 minus 9 is minus 4. You might want to ask the question, why minus 4? This is plus 5. Whenever we are dealing with two signs, in order for us to know whether we have to add or subtract, we have to multiply the two signs together. So we say plus times minus is minus. 5 minus 9 is the same as 9 minus 5, which is 4. And then we say the bigger number carries the sign. That is why 5 minus 9 is also minus 4. So all what we need to do, we divide both sides by minus in order to get rid of the negative sign attached to the y. So minus minus comes out, then y now is equal to 4. Minus minus comes out to y equals to 4. So therefore, x is equal to 3 and y equals to 4. Clear? Alright, that is all for example number one. Looking at the question given here, in mathematics, we need to know some mathematical rules. Looking at mathematical rules, it enables you to be fully convinced that your answer is correct or not. So let's take a look at the mathematical rules. Looking at mathematical rules, we now know the value of x and y. Now, after finding the value of x and y, if we substitute the value of x and y in equation 1, the answer must be equal to 7. If we substitute the value of x and y in equation 2, the answer must be equal to 5. If we substitute the value of x equals to 3, y equals to 4, in either equation 1 or equation 2, if the answer is not equal to 7 or 5, meaning that there is something wrong somewhere, so we need to go over the entire solution. That is the mathematical view. So let's take, for example, equation 1. X plus y equals to 7. So we say, but x is equal to 3, y is equal to 4. If we substitute x equals to 3, y equals to 4 into this equation 1, the answer will be equal to 7. So let's substitute x is 3 plus y is 4. 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. That is a mathematical rule. Substituting x equals to 3, y equals to 4 in equation 20. Anna wants to buy. So we take a look at equation 2. 3x minus y equals to 5. Both x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 4. Now let's substitute the value of x and y in equation 2. So see whether the answer will be equal to 5. So we say 3 into x, which is 3, minus y, which is 4. And so we also say equal to 5 because we don't know whether the answer will be equal to 5 or not. 3 times 3 is 9, minus 4, and 9 minus 4 is equal to 5. So meaning that the value of x and y, they are correct. Right? That's for elimination method. We are going to look at the same question again using substitution method. So, using substitution method, we have to make either x or y the subject of the formula in either equation 1 or equation 2. I might want to make x the subject of the formula in equation 1. You might want to make y the subject of the formula in equation 1. Another person might want to make x the subject of the formula in equation 2. Another person might want to make y the subject of the formula in equation 2. Regardless which letter we make the subject of the formula in which equation or in what equation, the answer must always be the same. So let us take x as the subject in equation 1. So we write the statement to say, make x the subject. Make x the subject of the formula. Make x the subject of the formula in equation 1. You might also ask, what do we mean by make x the subject of the formula in equation 1? Making x the subject of the formula in equation 1 simply means that x must be below, either on the left or the right hand side. If we already have x on the left hand side, x must be below on the left hand side, and all other values must be on the right hand side. For example, let us say we have alpha plus j equals to negative. Alpha plus j equals to negative. We want to make alpha the subject of the formula. All we need to do is take j over to the right hand side. So now on the left hand side, we are left with alpha equal to negative plus constant on the right hand side. Moving plus John from the left to the right, the plus John automatically changes to minus John. Fair? Alright. So let's go back to the question. Making x the subject of the formula in equation 1. That means we have x r, that equation 1 and x plus y equals to 7. In making x the subject, we have to move plus y from the left hand side to the right hand side. I repeat, making x the subject of the formula in equation 1, we have to move plus y from the left to the right. So the plus y automatically becomes minus y. So we are left with x equals to 7. Minus y. So I will make x the subject of the formula in equation 1. Let me go back again. Make x the subject of the formula in equation 1. We write what we have as equation 1. So we say x plus y equals to 7. Making x the subject, we have to move plus y from the left to the right. Moving plus y from the left to the right, then plus y automatically changes to minus y. So we have left with x equals to 7 minus y. After we have completed that one, all we need to do, we have to substitute x equals to 7 minus y in equation 2. There is no need for you to substitute x equals to 7 minus y in equation 1 again. No. Because we have already made x the subject in equation 1. So, all of this, we now substitute x equals equal to 7 minus 1 in equation 2. So we say substitute x equals to 7 minus y in equation 2. But we need to know what we have as equation 2. We have equation 2 as 3x minus y equals to 5. So wherever we see x, we now say value of x as 7 minus 1 in equation 2. So by substituting, we now write 3. Instead of writing x, we use the value of x, which is 3 into x, which is 7 minus y minus y equals to 5. By substituting x equals to 7 minus y in equation 2, 3 into x, which is 7 minus y bracket closed, minus y equals to 5. Now we expand. To expand, we will need to get rid of the bracket. So 3 times 7, 3 times minus y. 3 times 7 is 21, minus 3 times y, which is 3y, and then minus y equals to 5. We add the light and the light and add minus 3y and minus y. So all of these are zero. We now keep 21 constant, minus 3y minus y is minus 4y equals to 5. You might also ask the y minus 3y minus y equals minus 4y. So we say minus times minus is plus, 3y plus y is 4y, and then the number carries the sign. So from this point, because the prime value of y, take plus 21 over to the right hand side. So the plus 21 automatically becomes minus 21. So on the left hand side, we will see minus 4y equals to 5 minus 21. So on this one, minus 4y is equal to 5 minus 21 is minus 16. Because the bigger number carries the sign. So because we have to find the value of y, we now divide both sides by minus 4. Why am I dividing both sides by minus 4? Because the coefficient of y is minus 4. So we divide both sides by minus 4. So minus 4 and minus 4 cross out on the left hand side. And then the rest is y equals to minus 16 divided by minus 4. Minus and minus cross out. And then the rest is 16 divided by 4. So therefore, y is equal to 16 divided by 4, which is 4. We have already found the value of y. Now we have to substitute y equals to 4 in either equation 1 or equation 2 in order to determine the value of x. So we now say substitute y equals to 4 in equation 2 or equation 1 as we say. That is, what do we have as equation 2? We have equation 2 as 3x minus y equals to 5. So meaning that wherever we see y, we now replace the y to be 4. So 3x minus y, which is 4, equals to 5. Take minus 4 over to the right hand side. Why am I moving minus 4 in the left to the right? Because we have to find the value of x. So moving minus 4 from the left to the right, and on the left hand side, we have left 3x equals to 5 plus 4. Don't get confused. This minus 4 on the left hand side moving to the right hand side becomes plus 4. So 3x is equal to 5 plus 4, which is 9. So to find the value of x, we divide both sides by the coefficient of x, which is 3. Remember, the coefficient is the number of the variable to the left. So divide both sides by 3. 3 and 3 cross out, then x equals to 9 divided by 3, which is 3. So the same question here, we have solved the same question using elimination method and using substitution method. So it says therefore x is equal to 3 and y equals 4. So in that case, which one of the equation, which one of the solution includes the answer? And then